Hello friends, Navin this side from Retina Jama Photography. I'm a Nikon NPS photographer based in New Delhi. And today I'm gonna talk to you about the first hands experience of this new Nikon Z5 which I've just got from Nikon India for the hands-on experience. I'll be keeping it for a few days and might be making more videos with some sample photos as well. Since last decade, I've been religiously using Nikon for all sort of my assignments. From FM10 to the Z6, which I've been using from last year, the journey has been amazing so far. As we all know, Z6 or Z6 is an amazing camera. It's a compact beast. In fact, I would say on most of my assignments, I've been using it, and sometimes I prefer it more than the D5 in scenarios where I really need to travel as light as possible. In the last 2 years, Nikon has launched 4 mirrorless camera bodies, the Z5, Z6, Z7 and the Z50, which is a crop sensor body, and I am happy to say that I've used all 4 of them and I think I'm pretty happy with what I'm using right now. From last 7 decades, Nikon has been producing amazing camera equipments and lenses, and in the last 2 years, they have added 4 mirrorless cameras in their arsenal, and the most recent camera of their mirrorless arsenal is the Nikon Z5, which I've just got my hands on. I really wanted to have a look at this camera because primarily there are 2 reasons behind it. I would say the first one is it's cheaper than Z6. So basically I can really use it as a second body, and the second reason is that it's a full frame camera. So previously when Nikon launched Z50, I really wanted to get that camera because I have been looking out for a backup body of my mirrorless Z6. Like all the mirrorless cameras by Nikon, the Z5 has also been designed to use flawlessly with the Z series lenses and even the S series lenses. And if you don't own any of these, you can also use this camera with the F mount lenses, and that can be done with the help of the F to Z adapter, which is easily available out there. When I unboxed this camera, the first thing which I noticed was the fact that the top screen of this camera is missing. So what Nikon has done is they have actually placed a mode dial instead of the top screen, and I don't know, the top screen is quite helpful. I use it pretty much most of the times, but yeah, placing a mode dial here could be the reason of cost cutting or something like that. And the second important thing which I've noticed here is there are no buttons here. All the buttons have been shifted towards this side, or I would say they are not shifted, they have actually been removed completely. Also, Nikon also hurt the photographers out there, because when the Z6 and Z7 were launched 2 years ago, everyone was complaining about the fact that they only had a slot of 1 card, and that too the XQD. And this time they have given the option of using 2 SD cards. So basically there are 2 slots, and this can be really helpful if you are the one who loves to keep a backup of all your photos throughout your shoot. I don't do it much, but it's a great option for sure. Like all the other Z series cameras, this one is also weather sealed and dust proof. And the front and the top of this body is made up of magnesium alloy, which is usually found in the high-end cameras. I mean, if you get a D5, D6 or something like that, all those bodies are made up of magnesium alloy. So this is quite interesting. Talking about the specifications of this camera, this has a CMOS sensor of 24.3 megapixels and the company claims that it is not back illuminated. So technically speaking, if we talk about the fact that if the sensor is not back illuminated, that means the image quality, especially in the low light scenarios, is not that great. So I haven't tested in comparison with the Z6, but I mean, technically, if it's not back illuminated, obviously the low light image quality wouldn't be that great as of the Z6 or of the sensors which are back illuminated. Talking about the ISO of this camera, the range starts from 100, goes up to 51,200 and is expandable to 1,02,400, which is one stop lower than what the Z6 is offering. This small little piece of engineering has also got 273 points of face detection autofocus system, which is built on the sensor. Isn't that amazing? And this 273 point autofocus system covers the 90% area of the image. So that means if you are shooting horizontally or vertically, the 90% of the area of the image is getting covered by the autofocus points. So gone are the days when it was like damn difficult to focus on the farthest corners of the frame. So this is gonna be really helpful. Although Z6 also has the same feature, but I mean, within this price band, if you are getting the same autofocus system, I would say this is quite interesting. If you are into sports, action, or maybe wildlife photography, this is something which might not come in handy for you and might not serve the purpose, because the FPS which this camera is offering is 4.5, and for those sort of situations you definitely need a higher FPS. So maybe a Z6 or Z7 could be a better option, because Z6 is offering you 12 FPS and this one has 4.5, so there's a difference of almost one third. I mean, though it's one third, and I noticed about the buffer information, and I was trying to figure out if the buffer information was available online, but I couldn't find anything regarding the buffer on the official website of Nikon India or any other review websites. But I tested it on the Class 10 SD card for almost 102 photographs, and I really didn't get any sort of issue in terms of buffer. Talking about the battery life of this camera, the Z5 can actually shoot around 450 to 500 photographs when using the LCD panel. And I should tell you about the LCD panel as well. This is a 3.2-inch tiltable LCD panel, and it's a touchscreen. It's similar. It's like the same version what we get in the Z6. The best part is that it's a tilt screen, so it is really helpful when you are shooting something above the crowd, or maybe when you really need those interesting low angles. This is like quite helpful. The screen gets tilted like this. We often tend to use battery grips, and Z5 is also compatible with one of the battery grips offered by Nikon, and it is called MBN10. And Nikon claims that MBN10 can actually give you the power 1.8 times, and the best part of using that battery grip is that without losing any power, you can actually switch the batteries. So this is something really interesting when you are shooting a time lapse or an interview or anything which demands a lot of time, and the camera is not able to perform for that long, then you can use that battery grip and you can change in the middle of the shoot and there will be no power loss. Talking about the capabilities of this camera, this has an inbuilt option to create time lapses, and there are two modes to do that. You can actually create a time lapse within the camera and also choose the setting to save those RAW or JPG files separately as well, so that you can actually use those photographs later to make a time lapse manually on your system or computer, whatever. And this is like very interesting feature, because right away you can actually see whatever you have shot. And when it comes to time lapses, when we are shooting a lot of time in creating them, it's very important and it's very helpful to get a real quick view of what you have shot for so long. The new Nikon Z5 also has 5-axis image stabilization, and this one is inbuilt, and Nikon calls it IBIS. So basically, Nikon claims that this IBIS can actually increase the hand-holdable shutter speed time by 5 stops. So up till 5 exposure values, you can easily use this camera, and the images which this camera will be producing will be tack sharp. And to add on to it, this IBIS system works really well with video as well. I just shot like few really small clips, and I noticed though this IBIS doesn't really work great when you are walking really fast, but when you are holding this camera in your hand and shooting, when there is a very less movement, this works really well. I mean, it's flawless. Talking about the video capabilities of this camera, this one shoots 4K at 30p and Full HD at 60p. But there's a catch here. I mean, if you are the one who loves shooting 4K at full frame, this one is not meant for you. Because at 4K, this gives you a crop factor of 1.7x. So basically, if you are using a 50mm lens and using a 4K, it becomes 85mm because of the crop factor of 1.7x. And this might be useful to few, and few of you might not like it. Personally, this looks like an interesting thing to me, because if I get this as a second mirrorless body apart from my Z6, this could be really helpful in the fact that I don't need to carry a lot of my lenses to, you know, compensate with the focal length. Because if I can just carry a 35 and 50mm, I can be using it 35 and 50 on my Z6, and I can use it as a 59 and an 85 on my Z5. All in all, I would say about this camera that my verdict would be that Nikon has done a good deed of using the same electronic viewfinder which they are using in their Z6 and Z7, because this is one of the best available out there in the market, and it's very naturally looking. When you look through it, you really get a feel of a very it doesn't strain your eyes, and Nikon has used the very same electronic viewfinder in that. And apart from that, they have also used the tiltable screen, which comes really handy when you are shooting those low angles and top angles. Plus, I really love the fact that it has got two SD card slots, though I would have preferred an XQD and SD both, but that's okay. If it's an entry level mirrorless full frame, then this can actually serve the purpose for many photographers out there. And one more good thing about this camera is the 1.7x crop factor at the 4K. Although a lot of photographers, a lot of cinematographers might not like it, but for me, this could be really helpful. If I reiterate all the features of this camera again for you to conclude, I would say it's an entry-level full-frame mirrorless camera by Nikon, and this comes with 24.3 megapixel CMOS sensor. The sensor is XPEED 6, which is the most highly advanced sensor out there in the market right now. The camera has a tiltable screen. The ISO native range is 100 to 51,200, goes up to 1,02,400 as well. Comes with a dual card slot of SD. You can use ultra high speed cards in this camera. Along with that, this has a 5x image stabilization, which is really helpful in video as well, and it works flawlessly in the video. And this is compatible with all the Z series, S series, and even the F mount lenses with the use of an FTZ adapter. The Z5 also has inbuilt Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, and apart from that, this camera shoots really amazing videos with 4K at 30p at 1.7x crop factor and Full HD at 60p. I hope this small video might be useful for you, though I haven't shared anything which is not available out there on the internet, but this is my first look of the camera, the hands-on experience which I've just got. I might be posting more videos of the detailed review of this camera soon.